Hey guys, guess what? The war's over. We can go home and celebrate. Yes, in a move to make my episodes of The Shelf Life of Milk stored in a sauna, it was recently announced.
U.S. futures rising after the White House said its spat with China is on hold for now.
We're putting the trade war on hold. So right now we have agreed to put the tariffs on hold while we try to execute the framework.
We're putting the war on hold, which, my gosh, can't we commit to anything? Right now the United States is like a boy who's on a break with 5 different girls. I don't want to put a label on our relationship. Maybe you're a currency manipulating, job stealing authoritarian. Or maybe you're a genius friend whose jobs need protecting. The terms of this agreement might leave some pleased by the idea that this is temporary, because critics are saying we give up a lot more than we get. So what happened? Well, a few weeks ago, China gave us a list of 9 items they wanted to see changed, because apparently they thought our State Department was incapable of figuring out what China wanted, so they just decided to tell us. It's like when you think your dad seems to be getting you a baseball bat for Christmas, so you need to remind him that you really want a PS4. Couldn't imagine what those negotiations would be like if they hadn't laid out what they wanted. President Xi. Wow, your name is Xi? I won't make fun of you on Twitter for having a female name. Plus, I'll throw in a few signed hats if you start buying more from our stuff. Alright, so what happened? Well, first let's talk about what we gave up, because on Sunday, the Trump administration surprised the business world by announcing it would pull back on a plan to impose tariffs on Chinese goods. Now, in Trump's defense, Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin, or Jared Fogle trying to start a second career after hearing the White House doesn't do background checks, said, "We're putting the tariffs on hold." Great, glad we got that cleared up on the US's position on this deal. At the same time, US Trade Representative Leitzinger said, "As this process continues, the United States may use all of its legal tools to protect our technology through tariffs." Great, so maybe that hold isn't happening because the guy in charge of trade seemed to not have gotten that major memo. Well, never fear, because to clarify everything, enter National Economic Council Director Larry Kudlow, who said on Face the Nation yesterday,
"But did he take that threat of $150 billion in tariffs off the table?"
But look, I don't think we're at that stage yet.
Okay, so it's clear. We have not yet agreed to what we agree to yet. That is literally every position you could have. Most people think that Mnuchin's statement that we're putting a hold on tariffs is the reality, though, because that's the only way you could put the trade deal on hold. I mean, that is the trade war. So is that all we gave to China? Because if that is all we did, we just announced a few months ago we were going to put on sanctions, and then announced recently, you know what? Never mind. Well, then this whole thing would just be a massive waste of time. Well, never fear, because we gave up a little more. Now, I want to emphasize that my current security clearance is Google search, and this is being kept under wraps, which is always a sign that you got a great deal. So how much did you end up spending for that car, Bob? Oh, you know, some money. The next big thing that is rumored to be going on is investment access. According to a Marco Rubio tweet that said, "Hashtag China is winning the negotiations. Their concessions are things they plan to do anyways. In exchange, they invest in the US without limits. Hashtag losing." Ooh, hitting him with a hashtag losing. Just another sick burn in the storied career of professional roaster Marco Rubio.
And you know what they say about men with small hands? You can't trust them. You can't trust them. You can't trust them.
Good one. Unfortunately for you, they say the same thing about people with small crowds. This was also confirmed by, and I'm quoting from a Chicago Times article, a lobbyist familiar with the deliberations who isn't authorized to speak publicly about the administration's decision-making and spoke on the condition of anonymity. Alright, great. So we're going with Little Marco and an anonymous lobbyist. Sounds reputable. Now, the reason why I chose this, and I think it could be plausible and worth reporting as something that could have happened, was that this was something on the list of Chinese demands from America, and something that, on the surface, doesn't sound like a bad thing. I mean, who would freak out about more Chinese money coming into the American economy? On a list of the US's problems, that would probably be down there with too many Italians taking our jobs. So, why do we not want Chinese money? Well, according to Reuters, there is a recent Mnuchin-led meeting to discuss the latest draft of legislation that would tighten up scrutiny of foreign investment in order to limit Chinese efforts to acquire sophisticated US technology. Turns out that when you put your money into something, you're probably gonna want to know what it is you bought. Unfortunately, that generally involves revealing some intellectual property that China could then steal. Now, a progress report for this was set to be released on Monday, the 21st of May. But most people think that, after this negotiation, that bill might get filed next to Trump's tax returns. So, next comes ZTE, a country that is being sanctioned for breaking US sanctions on Iran and North Korea, and whose fate really depends on who you ask in the White House. From what people have said, though, it seems like the sanctions on ZTE are going to be removed. But don't worry, because director of the United States National Economic Council, Larry Kudlow, said, "Do not, please do not expect ZTE to get off scot-free. It ain't gonna happen." Hey, at least he said please. Although, sorry, but I know Republicans have a history of punishing companies like a bad parent. "Oh, I know you made a mistake setting fire to that person's house, but maybe if I regulate you less, you won't do it again. Now, go have fun with your friends." Alright, so now, what did we get out of this deal?
We told you earlier, North Korea is again tonight threatening to cancel next month's scheduled summit between Kim Jong-un and President Trump. But China is putting pressure on Kim to stay the course.
Woohoo! The idea that a fair amount of people thought was bad to begin with is now the prize. Great. Now that wasn't it. There was also commitments to increase imports of American liquefied natural gas products by $9 billion. Well, the amount could be even larger if the US can resolve its logistics bottleneck. Oh wow, China, you're so generous, buying more gas from us. What a strong gesture. That's like the US agreeing to buy more oil from Iraq. Phew, I was worried we weren't gonna sell one of the most demanded resources on the market. It's all remarkably vague besides that though, with speculation that China will increase purchases of things they already planned on increasing purchases of. So yeah, it's all pretty murky as to what we're getting. Although, what we seem to be sacrificing is mostly comprised of things Trump has threatened to do. While we're here, I do have to mention, as it might be connected down the road, Trump has a direct financial interest in a major real estate development project essentially underwritten by a state-owned Chinese bank. And this is a major investment. We're talking $500 million. And let me tell you, that would be more than enough to make me change my votes. This was all announced a week after he suggested we try to start saving Chinese jobs. And I'm not going to jump to any conclusions, but we'll just see what Mueller has to say about a month from now. Overall, it seems like we threatened to start a trade war, and when China stepped up, we backed down. Basically,
I moved on her like a
thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, if you want to support nonpartisan comedic reporting, please subscribe to my channel and like below. Thank you for watching.